Give me a bit of distortion. Guitar to the left. Vocals to the right. A bit of reverb on the vocals. Hey folks, welcome along to Nail Guitar Skills. I'm Andy, and a little bit of fun to start up there. How is that possible? One of the most scary parts of getting into guitar, which is sort of one of the outer aspects of guitar, is recording. So today, I'm gonna break down how that was possible. How did I do those things? And the answer is using a multi-track interface. I'm recording on my computer. I'm gonna break down why this is so important. The key of a multi-track interface is that it gives you, remember this, really important word, control. Control is what you need. For most of my guitar lessons, I just use an acoustic guitar and I have a microphone just hiding just out of view here. And what I do is I point it down so that I have a mix of both. That works great for guitar lessons, but if you're recording for purely audio purposes, so you want a good recording of your band or, you know, yourself as a singer soloist, that sort of thing, that doesn't cut it. You need control. And that's where a multi-track interface comes in. Basically, a multi-track interface is the thing that joins your microphone through to your computer. And if you have more than one source of audio, so that means guitar, that's one source of audio. If you are singing as well, that's two sources of audio. If you have a bass player as well, that's three sources of audio. If you have a drummer, you've got a whole heap of mics on the drum kit as well, and obviously the number goes up. So for each source of audio, you need an individual track so that you can have control over each of those instruments, each of those microphone inputs. So today I'm going to show you what I'm using and how I weave that little bit of magic there at the start, and give you some great options if you're just getting into the world of recording and take away a lot of the scariness. So the interface that I'm using is by Focusrite. It is one of their Scarlett range, and it is the 18i8. And something really cool is the fact that it's red. It actually fits the Nail Guitar branding, which is just beautiful. And a big thank you to Focusrite for gearing up with us to collaborate for this video. And the best bit about Focusrite is their focus on ease of use and accessibility. This makes them a great choice if you want to turn what you've learned on the guitar into actual recorded music. You can check out the Scarlett range via the link in the description down below. So it's really important to understand that this interface here is what connects our guitar and our microphone through to our computer, which is where we're doing the recording. So if we have a look on the computer here, you'll see these two red lines that we've got here. This one represents our microphone recording, and this one represents our guitar recording. So I haven't played any guitar yet since you've been watching this. If I play some guitar, you'll notice some little lines appear there. So that is what the interface is doing, hence it being called an interface. It connects everything to the computer so that you can record. I'm using Logic here. If you own a Mac, you will get GarageBand Free, which is the baby brother of Logic, which is a paid product. If you're using a PC, you've got lots of options there as well. So running through the front of the interface, first of all, you'll notice that when I talk through the mic, we have this little light up here, which is a really nice visual reference. So that is our volume knob right there. And this is the mic cable plugged into this first channel of the interface. This little button down here that says 48V is for condenser microphones. If you have a microphone that is a condenser microphone, that means it's a microphone that needs to be powered. And so the interface will do that for you when you press that button if you need that for a condenser microphone. The next channel that we've got here is our guitar lead plugged in. And it's the same thing. So that's something that takes away the scariness straight away, is realizing you've got a lot of the same thing over and over again. In this interface, we have eight channels. We have four on the front where we can plug in, and we have another four on the back, which we'll see afterwards. So I've got two empty channels that I'm not using here. This is our main volume, our main output for our speakers. We've got a mute button up here. I've also got an indication of MIDI signals as well. I'll tell you more about that when we get to the back. And then over here, we have two headphone inputs. You can see my plugged in there already. There's our volume for each of those. Love that it's got two independent headphone inputs, because if you're working with, maybe you're working with a singer and you're playing guitar and you want different mixes, one of you wants to be able to hear more of, maybe the singer wants to hear more of the vocals and you as the guitarist wants to hear more of the guitar, you can do that. There's actually a routing software that comes with your interface which allows you to control all of those little variables there. So that's a really nice advantage. A lot of interfaces only have a single headphone output there, so that's really nifty. So looking at the back now, here is the other four inputs that I was telling you about. These ones are just jack inputs for instruments like guitar and that sort of thing. We then have our monitor outs, which is basically our outputs to go to our speakers. Here we've got an optical input, if you have a piece of gear that has optical. And here is the USB cable, which plugs our interface into the computer and sends all the information there. Here is what I was talking about before, MIDI. MIDI is sort of the digital music language. If you have a keyboard or like an electric drum kit, that works on MIDI, so it's nice to have MIDI functionality in there rather than having to buy an additional unit for interfacing MIDI into your computer. And this one is a Spdif. That's even a bit above me. I always hear about Spdif, but I've never used it myself. And here is our power and our power switch. So there it is for you. I hope that takes away a bit of the scariness of your first steps into recording. A big thank you again to Focusrite for getting involved with us on this video. And check out the Scarlett range. Find a interface that is right for you. You know, have a think about how many inputs that you're going to be using, and then you know, check out their range that they've got available there. There is a good amount of options. You definitely don't need an 8-input interface like I've got there. You can start out with as little as 2 inputs. So, my name's Andy, this is Nail Guitar Skills. As always, if you haven't subscribed already, be sure to do that, and thank you for your like. Catch you for your next video.